Okay, let's look at the homework 2.6, problem number one. All right, so we want to find the y prime by implicit differentiation and solve for y and take the regular derivative. All right, so let's do that. All right, so implicit differentiation. All right, so we're gonna take the derivative directly from here. So if you take the derivative with respect to x, you will get, so let's see, this is just written in x, so it's a regular derivative. So put 2 in front. 2 times 7 is 14. And subtract 1 from the power, so it's just going to be x, right? 14x. And derivative of negative y squared would be negative 2y, but we have to multiply by dy over dx, or you can use y prime if you want, right? And then derivative of the right-hand side is going to be 0 since it's a constant. All right. Then we just need to solve for y prime. All right. So let's do that. So first, I'm going to just subtract 14x from both sides. Then you have a negative 2y times y prime is equal to negative 14x. Right, so you know to isolate y prime, we can just divide through by negative 2y. Right, so you have a y prime is equal to, right, so you have let's see, negative 14 x divided by negative 2y. Right, so you can cancel, so 2, negative 2. And negative 14, so it's going to be 7, right? So you're going to have 7x over y, right? So y prime is 7x over y, right? Then if you want to solve for y first, so I guess first I'm going to start with the 7x squared, right? Minus y squared is equal to 9, right? So subtract 7x squared will give you negative y squared is equal to 9 minus 7x squared, right? And then I'm gonna just multiply both sides by negative 1. That way we can get x squared. And I'm gonna write the 7x squared first and minus 9. Right, then therefore we can take the square root. So y is equal to, right, don't forget plus or minus, square root of 7x squared minus 9. Right, then we have to take the derivative. So I'm going to write it as a plus or minus, right, 7x squared minus 9 raised it to the 1/2 power. Right, so we can take the derivative. So y prime is equal to, right, plus or minus, put that there. So put 1/2 in front and keep exactly the same inside function. So I'm doing a chain rule here. Subtract 1 from the power, so it's power rule. Right, multiply by derivative inside. That would be 14x. Right. So if you want, we can write it as plus or minus, right? Then 2 and 14 cancel out, so that would be 7. So we can write it as 7x on top. Then you have a negative sign, so 7x squared minus 9 lives downstairs, and 1/2 corresponds to square root. So we can write it that way. All right, so let's see. Let's type it in. So 7x over square root of 7x squared minus 9. All right, so let's type it in. All right, so what we got was, let's see, fraction 7x over y. And on the bottom, plus or minus, right, fraction. And 7x, then we have a square root, let's see, square root of 7x squared minus 9. All right, so we have that. Let's see. Let's make sure. Let's stop. So let's see if this is correct. Submit for testing. All right, it came back and looks like we got the part A and part B correctly. All right, that's it. I hope that this was clear.